This is Lawnswood Light Railway, begun in 1994. The line runs between Cooper's Lodge Works and Lawnswood. Shed sidings provides loops for steaming up and passing. The railway is a line in a garden, with many large and colourful perennials. The main line continues past the engine shed to the green. The green has three loops for passing and steaming up and is the shadiest part of the garden. The main line then climbs gently past Penryn sidings back to Lawnswood. One of the positive results of lockdown was the replacement of an old bridge with a metal replica of Tanny Bulk. There is a branch line from the main line running down to the wharf. This is the wharf station. The arch bed provides a link between the two stations and ensures a continuous run. Russell is a 262T, Hunslet number 901, built in 1906. Russell was scratch built during 2019 and completed in 2020. Beddgelert is an 064 ST, Hunslet number 206, built in 1878 for the North Wales Narrow Gauge Railway Company. It was scratch built in 2015. Beddgelert is seen here pulling four North Wales Narrow Gauge Railway Company coaches. The coaches were made from Perfect World kits and include number 24 and the Gladstone car. James Spooner, FR number 8, was designed by G.P. Spooner and delivered by Builders Avonside in 1872. James Spooner was scratch built in 2018 using roundhouse Taliesin bogies. James Spooner approaches the green with a Colonel Stevens train. James Spooner leaves the green on the main line above the Wharf station, where the drinkers have already started. The loco is climbing the bank past a gravity train. James Spooner passes over Tannyborg Bridge with an up train, including bogie coaches, goods vehicles and slate wagons. Taliesin, FR number 7, was built by the Vulcan Foundry in 1876. This early version of Taliesin, 1887, is based on a David Bailey boiler. David Bailey frets for the bodywork and a Taliesin bogie from Roundhouse. Here she runs into Lawnswood station and then onto the turntable. Taliesin leaves the green with a passenger train on its way to Cooper's Lodge Works. This is Countess, made by Pierce Locos in 1995. Countess is seen here, running past the engine house and the pond, down to the green. The passengers are making sure they are observing social distancing. Countess departs past the signal box and through Llywelyn Tunnel. Countess passes Penryn Loop on its way to Lawnswood Station. The coaches are of the same vintage as the engine, having been made by Brambright and their resin. The engine runs round the train, ready for the return journey. Countess pulls into Lawnswood Station, which is a replica of Welshpool Raven Square. This is a roundhouse model, built in 2004 with the large gas tank, drain cocks and whistle. Llywelyn departs Lawnswood Sheds on its way to Cooper's Lodge Works to pick up the first train of the day. The train drifts down the bank on its way to the green past Penryn Loop. The coaches were built by the Midland Railway Carriage and Wagon Company of Shrewsbury. The closed bogey coach is Perfect World, and the other coaches and the brake van are scratch built. With the drain cocks fully open, it departs the green on its way to Cooper's Lodge Works. Llywelyn is pulling a chocolate and cream set. Two Perfect World coaches, one mesh sided and one summer coach, and two coaches based on Imp models. This is a Friog model of Harlech Castle, built in Fairbourne in 1995. Gwyndedd is a Bagley Drury diesel, number 3767 of 1983. It was later modified by the FR to fit their loading gauge in 1988. The branch line descends quite steeply to the wharf alongside the central path of the garden.